Today I've got a brief highlight overview video for you to kind of showcase some of the unboxing and the assembly process of the AtGames Legends pinball machine, as well as give you some specifications and measurements and details, things that might be helpful if you're going to pick this up at a retail store environment so you can know what to expect, or if you've already got this on pre-order so you can really know what to expect should it arrive on your doorstep. Also be showing you some of the inner workings and the layouts of all the components inside this machine, so if you got an idea for tinkering, things like that, this will give you a little idea of what to expect there. If you're looking for gameplay, I did a 2.5 hour live stream the other day that's on this channel that you can check out that is solely dedicated playing the games on this machine. I will, of course, have a thorough, dedicated, full-length review on this machine later on in the channel, but today we're just going to go ahead and check out the inner workings. So let's go ahead, get after it. The assembly process is literally a breeze. It'll honestly probably take you 15 minutes tops. Literally all you're doing is attaching the pinball legs to the table body. You're setting the back box on top of the body, screwing it down with 4 screws, and then making 2 cable connections. Very simple, very easy. It'll probably honestly take you more time to unpackage everything and take away all the protective padding and layers and things like that than it will to assemble the machine. One thing I will tell you right now is it does come with this nice little tube barrel key so you can get in the back box into the table body. Do not lose this key. They do supply some nice little gaffer tape so you can tape it on the back of the machine, but if you do lose it and for whatever reason you need to get back there, which technically you don't to enjoy the pinball machine experience, but if you're a modder or a tinkerer and you want to get back there and operate on it all the time, don't lose your key, because if you do, you'll be SOL as far as accessing the back panels of the machine. So keep that in mind. In regards to modding, simplest, easiest mods you could do on this obviously would be change out the buttons, change out the speakers. You could change the plunger if you want, but It's okay to me. However, if you wanted to change the playfield, again, don't know why you would, but if you wanted to change the playfield, or if perhaps say you wanted to stream your gameplay as opposed to having a top-down camera view, you will need to find an LVDS to HDMI connection, because right now this is running off an LVDS connection. You don't have an HDMI input, so if you wanted to tinker again, replace the screen, again, don't know why you would, but if you wanted to, you would have to convert that signal from the PCB. Additionally, the second screen back here, 15.6 inches, if you wanted to put a bigger screen in that for whatever reason, again, you would have to find a correct adapter because it uses a ribbon cable connection, so it's a completely different connection than what we got here. So again, can it be done? Sure, anything can be done with time or money. But really, that's it. I just wanted to show you a super simple overview of the machine. Again, check out the gameplay live stream if you want to check out the gameplay, and look for a thorough in-depth review later on in the channel. But until then, guys, thanks for checking out the video. See you guys next year.